This video is brought to you by Dynamic Custom Beadworks. Head over to dynamicbeadworks.com now to get your own custom video game sprite.
You got the touch! You got the power!
Yeah, I can't open doors. Alright, Shiga, have a good night, buddy. Okay, that's a big ol' nope. Come on now. What are we missing? Can't go that way. Can we go through that door? No, we can't. And, okay. Open window.
Oh, you can't be serious.
Wasn't I just out here?
Late breakfast. I don't understand why people play games on easy. Shit. Nathan's like short people problems. Yeah. Hey, King Bay, how you doing? No, I actually just got done explaining that. Like, I mean, if you want to play it on like super ultra death fuck your mother mode, then hey, be my guest. Like, most of the time, If it's like a single player game, and I know without a shadow of a doubt, there is no difference in God. He wouldn't change over. If I know there is no difference in content or it doesn't change the story at all, I'll play it on normal or easy. Because a single player game is like I don't want to sit there and get angry and frustrated because I run up against some guy and I get hit twice and I'm dead. I want to fucking enjoy the game. Oh yeah, this game is not a cakewalk. Like, even on normal, like, you can see I'm having a couple issues. But yeah, truth be told, and like, I'll stand by the statement, and I'll add to it just a little bit. Instead of two, like, the three big differences you will see in a game on easy mode and a game on hard mode is the amount of damage you do, the amount of damage the enemy does to you, and how many enemies there are. That's essentially it.
That's good.
And I mean, if you're not concerned with all that shit, then fuck it. Play the game on easy if that's what you want to do. Alright, where's the other guy shooting from? Oh, he's shooting from up there. Yep. Come to daddy. Come here.
Oh boy.
Oh shit. Come here.
That'll shut him up.
Let's see here. Also, with story time, do you play every game for that series? Have I played Killer is Dead? No, I've never played those. I haven't played Killer 7 either. What sucks is when a developer cheats you on the game experience by choosing an easier level. Yeah, I mean, a lot of the times, like, you can, let's see, Halo. Halo is the one that sticks out in my mind the most, because you, like, you have, like, easy, normal, heroic, and then legendary. And, like, the default difficulty is heroic. And it even says, like, on the screen, heroic, how Halo was meant to be played. The games are pretty easy, even on hard. The enemies are very predictable, sort of like Time Crisis. The point of the series is the story, in my opinion. Yeah, and I totally agree, like, the main point of Uncharted is the story itself. I mean, and I'm just running it on normal. And it's like, it's just right. Like, it's a good amount of challenge. Holy shit, that's a lot of people. The difficulty on normal for Uncharted is, like, in my opinion, I think it's perfect. I'm not getting overly frustrated about anything. It's a good amount of challenge. I'm having fun with it, and we're still getting to see the story. Oh shit, that's a mounted gun.
Grenade!
Another grenade!
Crap.
I'm surprised KFAM hasn't posted in a while. You will actually find that out about KFAM. Like, he's in lurker mode right now, because chances are, he's either playing something, or he fucking fell asleep. Ryvents has fallen asleep in the channel before, KFAM has fallen asleep before. Which, I mean, that's okay. I mean, the whole point of, story time is just chill out, watch the gameplay, relax, and just overall, just have a nice, chill evening. And it gives me a break from doing fighting games, and allows me to play the games in my library that I want to do, but haven't been able to, because I've been playing Mortal Kombat, or I've been playing Injustice, or I've been playing Halo. Oh, that was pointless. Am I supposed to go up here? Yeah, maybe we need to go up a little bit higher. I haven't, but Lord knows I can be busy. Yeah. Like, pretty much every single one of my moderators, they're not just hanging out in the chat. They're also doing other stuff.
It's either very good.
Which, I mean, that's very bad. That's perfectly fine with me. I mean, number one, I don't chat in every single stream I go into. Half the time I am in lurker mode. And, I'm almost always, and I do mean almost always, doing something while I'm watching a stream.
What the hell's she doing?
Hello?
Buka Pintu!
Siabaini, Pichara Sekara!
Sialano! Chepatan Buka Pintu!
It worked!
There he is!
Up there! Get on the gun!
Oh boy.
You just had to say something, didn't you, Nathan? Nah, I'm not wasting a magnum round on that. Oh, you're pretty much Beatrix Kiddo from Kill Bill. Nice! Those graphics HD? Yeah, because we're playing the Nathan Drake collection, so, like, everything's had the HD overhaul, everything's running at 60 frames a second. All the goodies. Is from the creator of Lollipop Chainsaw. Yeah, I mean, just the whole concept of it, like, I looked at it and it seemed cool. It was just, it wasn't very high on the priority list of games I wanted to play, that's all. Alright, well, fuck. Why do I feel like I'm... Oh, wait, because that's the gate that opened. Okay. Yeah, shit!
Okay.
Well, crap. Oh, okay. Here we go. Will I do a day with MKX and Injustice, but also throw in some Budokai HD too? Bad news about Dragon Ball Z Budokai. Number one, I don't have it. Number two, that game has sentimental and emotional attachment to it, and this is a touch hard to talk about, but Dragon Ball Z Budokai, I have kind of like personally swore I would never play that game again.
This place could use a good plumber.
It was a game that,
son of a bitch, where did they
my open? Best friend pretty much considered him a brother type of thing. That was, and his name was Mikey. Me and him played Dragon Ball Z Budokai and Budokai 3. Like, we played those games religiously. And, a few years back, I think it's been about 8 years or so now, Mikey was hit by a drunk driver on New Year's Eve, and when he died, everybody had like their personal things and effects that they put in the casket with him, and I put a CD in there of songs that me and him, like, really, really loved, and I put I put my copy of Dragon Ball Z Budokai 3 in the casket with him. And I pretty much told him that I would never play the game again.
There he is!
And I'm saying this during a firefight. So you're saying it's too emotional for you. Yes, that is exactly what I'm saying. Like, I honestly don't think I could emotionally handle playing Dragon Ball Z Budokai again. I really don't think I could emotionally handle it. And I'm sorry if you guys are disappointed at that, or I'm pretty sure there's a troll or two in the chat that's going to wind up popping up and calling me a pussy or some shit like that, but fuck you. Yeah, like, playing that game again, it would remind me of Mikey, and I can't do that. I can't do it. I'll play Dragon Ball Xenoverse. I'll play that all day long for you if you guys want. But, yeah, you will never see Budokai HD or Budokai 3 on this channel. You never will. Okay. Anyway, back to the game, running around in a sewer and not knowing where the fuck to go. You would love to see me play Xenoverse? No problem. I will happily play Xenoverse. Alright, there has got to be something I'm missing. No. There we go. Good trick to level up new characters quick in that game is as soon as you make them collect the Dragon Balls in Dangerous Duo Warriors Never Rest, it gives you 15 levels. Oh yeah. Dude, we already did the story mode on the channel, and trust me, every chance I had to run the exploits to get the Dragon Balls really fast, you best believe I fucking did it. Okay, yeah, that's raising the water level. Good. Sorry if I got incredibly quiet after telling that story, but I mean,
Jesus, Elena, where are
you? I've told personal stories, like stuff that has happened to me outside of the stream. Like, I've talked about that stuff before, but it's always been like fun and cool experiences and stuff. Like,
wait a minute.
No, nobody ever wants to hear about the bad shit that ever happened to you. So,
oh, son of a bitch.
Oh, don't!
Do I always get myself into this?
Poke your head out, I know you want to. Thank you. Son of a...
Here we go.
Okay, right on, little buzz. I will add you... Once we're done playing this for tonight. Come on, heal. I love how I'm just going for headshots now. You need to be cool or quiet sometimes just to let things out, so it's okay. Yeah, thank you everybody in the chat for understanding. Like, I'm glad that you guys, like, I mean, was it nice to talk about it and not have people try and troll the fuck out of me for it or anything like that? It was actually quite nice that I could share that with you guys, and you guys were actually accepting of it and everything, and consoling and stuff. Thank you guys. That's really nice of you. Do I have any 3DO games? No. Because number one, I don't own a 3DO, and I definitely don't know anyone who does. Fuck off, bird. Well, that was close. My cousin used to have a 3DO. God. Like, I don't even remember anything that ever came out on the 3DO. I think there was, like, the only ones that I remember were, like, Rayman. And that's because, like, fucking Rayman came out on everything. And, the Daedalus Encounter, because I used to have a subscription to GamePro back in the day. And they plugged the shit out of the Daedalus Encounter because Tia Carrere was in it. Those of you that don't know who Tia Carrere is... Any of you guys that watched Wayne's World, she was the chick that played Cassandra. God, Nathan is a nimble little bastard. Best game he had was Sherlock Holmes. Yep. Drove us nuts for like a month trying to solve one of the cases. Samurai Showdown. Killing Time, Slayer, Dungeons and Dragons, Hell Corpse Killer. Oh wow. There was a lot of shit that came out on 3DO, huh? Alright bro, I'm off to bed. Enjoy the Tumblr. I sent everything to you. Let KFAM have it too, please. Not a problem, dude. I will be sure to do that. Thank you again for making that. That shit was, like, super awesome. Really, there's nothing. Ugh. That sucks. Alright, anybody see where I was supposed to go? I should play the Walking Dead game if I haven't. I'm new, by the way. Yeah, like, I saw you, Spikey. I'm more than likely, honestly, I probably won't do the Walking Dead games, just because I don't like... Like, Telltale Games, that's a great company. But... It's just not my kind of game, that's all. How was my day? My day was pretty uneventful. Like, I went to work, played Metal Gear Solid 5 while I was at work, because we were slow and I was bored. And, came home, ate dinner, watched The Walking Dead, and now I'm streaming. Why do I feel like there's something I missed up in that tower? And am I going to play Minecraft Story Mode? No, probably not, because I am not a fan. I am not a fan of Minecraft at all. I have a feeling Edith's part of the wolves. I don't know if I'd go that far, but something there is definitely more than meets the eye to the wolves. Absolutely there is. No, keep the grenade launcher. We want the grenades, just give us those. Thank you. Oh my god, where the fuck am I supposed to go? Okay, cool. Yeah, what's up, Tokyo?
Alright. Where the hell is she?
I fucking knew it.
Okay.
Oh, shit. Ooh, ooh, give me that.
Oh, great.
Oh, crap. Oh, God. I so did not mean to do that. The reason why I'm a good streamer is how much I interact with the chat. Well, I mean, that's very nice of you to say. Like, honestly, I hope that's not my only good quality, because I don't want to get it to the point that, like, say I do get, like, big baller streamer status, and the stream is moving so fast that I just can't keep up with it. Like, is that going to make me not be a good streamer because I'm not interacting as much because I can't keep up with the chat? I mean... These are things I legitimately worry about. I mean, there's more than just that. Yeah, I mean, you're probably right. Who's next? Enemy's hard to kill. A guy got shot and went over the fucking railing. Nathan's got the Halo 1 pistol.